Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the structure of smooth muscles and their types. Let's get started. A smooth muscle is made up of multiple smooth muscle fibers. The shape of the individual fiber is fusiform, which is round in the center and tapering at each end. The contractile elements inside the fiber are our familiar friends actin and myosin. You must be remembering them from the skeletal muscles. However, in smooth muscle, they are arranged differently. In skeletal muscle, the actin filaments of neighboring sarcomere are attached at Z-discs. And in between actins of two Z-discs, we have myosin, right? In smooth muscle, the overall idea of keeping myosin in between actins is similar. But at the ends instead of Z-disc, we have a structure called dense bodies. Actin filaments radiate from there. And in between actin filaments of two dense bodies, we have myosin filaments. There are many such random arrangements throughout the fiber. Some dense bodies are attached to the membrane, and others are dispersed inside the cell. This makes the contractile machinery of the cell. Some of the membrane-bound dense bodies may be attached to the adjacent fiber. This allows force generated by one fiber to be transmitted to the neighbor fibers as well. So this was inside an individual smooth muscle fiber. Now, depending on whether an individual muscle fiber operates independently or in harmony with all other cells inside the muscle, the smooth muscles are broadly divided into two types: multi-unit smooth muscles and unitary smooth muscles. In multi-unit smooth muscle, each fiber operates independently. In this, each muscle fiber is covered by a layer of basement membrane-like substance that separates fibers from one another. Also, each fiber is innervated by a single nerve ending. Because of this, individual fibers can operate independently of each other. It's like there are multiple contractile units within a single muscle. That's why such muscles are called multi-unit smooth muscles. This intricate detailing allows fine control of the muscle. Examples of multi-unit smooth muscles are muscles in the iris and ciliary body, and piloerector muscle of the skin. So this was multi-unit smooth muscle. Now let's talk about unitary smooth muscles. In this, neighboring fibers adhere to one another at multiple points. Because of this, the force generated in one muscle fiber can be transmitted to the next. Also, their cytoplasm is connected by gap junctions, and this allows free electrical and chemical communication between neighboring cells. Because of such an arrangement, the entire muscle contracts as a single unit or a syncytium, and that's why they are called unitary smooth muscle or syncytial smooth muscle. They are controlled largely by non-nervous stimuli. Such muscles are widely seen in walls of viscera, for example, the gastrointestinal tract, bile ducts, uterus, etc. So these were types of smooth muscles. Now let's have a quick summary. Smooth muscles are made up of small fusiform muscle fibers. Their contractile elements are basically similar to those in the skeletal muscle, but they are organized in a different way. In multi-unit smooth muscle, each fiber operates independently, whereas in unitary smooth muscle, all the muscle fibers contract as a single unit. That's it for this video.